Now let's see non-ideal solutions having negative deviation from Raoult's law. We have already seen non-ideal solutions having positive deviation from Raoult's law. Now let us see non-ideal solutions having negative deviation from Raoult's law. So in the case of solutions, we know that there is solvent-solute interaction and solute-solute interaction. So in the case of non-ideal solutions also, we can see there is solvent-solute interaction. That means A-B interaction. If solvent is represented by A and solute is represented by B, there is A-B interaction and A-A interaction, and also B-B interactions are there in the case of non-ideal solutions. So if this is having a negative deviation from Raoult's law, the reason is why there is negative deviation from Raoult's law. The reason is the solvent-solute interaction is greater. So the solvent-solute interaction is greater than solvent-solvent interaction and solute-solute interaction. That means A-B interaction is greater than AA interaction and BB interaction. So that is the reason why this solution is having negative deviation from Raoult's law. So AB interaction is greater than AA interaction and BB interaction. That means AB interaction, so the interaction between solvent and solute is stronger. So that is why it is having a negative deviation. In the case of solution, A and B are the components. If there is a strong interaction between A and B, if the interaction between A and B is very strong, or the force of attraction between A and B is very strong, we know that there is less vapors will be formed in the on the liquid surface. So if the interaction between A and B is very strong, or the force of attraction between A and B is very strong, there is less vapors are formed on the surface of the liquid, and there is less vapor pressure. So due to that less vapor pressure, we can say that there is negative deviation from Raoult's law. So in this case also, we can draw a graph. So in the case of ideal solution, we have drawn the graph like this. So in the case of non-ideal solution and having negative deviation, we know that the vapor pressure is less, and the graph will be, in the case of, this is the PA in the case of ideal solution, but in this case the PA will be like this. That means the vapor pressure is lower in this case since it is negative deviation. So this dotted line represents PA, and in the case of ideal solution, this straight line represents PB. In this case it is again lower, and this dotted line represents PB in the case of negative deviation, and this straight line is P total in the case of ideal solution, but in this case it is again lower, and this dotted line represents P total. So these dotted lines represents the negative deviation. That shows there is a negative deviation. Actually, this is a graphical representation. So this is a graphical representation of the behavior of non-ideal solutions having negative deviation from Raoult's law. Having negative deviation from Raoult's law. So this is the graphical representation. Now let's see some examples of non-ideal solutions. So non-ideal solutions having positive deviation, the examples are acetone ethanol solution and acetone benzene solution. So these are two sets of examples. They are showing positive deviation from Raoult's law. And non-ideal solutions having negative deviation from Raoult's law, phenol aniline. So this is one set of solution. The other one is acetone and CCl4. So these are two sets of solutions having, or they are showing, negative deviation from Raoult's law. So this is about non-ideal solutions.